So dear students, today I am here with the same topic, direct and indirect speech, which is also known as reported speech. This is the second part of our narration. So when we make sentence in indirect speech, usually we change the tense to the corresponding past tense. So this is what today I am going to explain. So before that, let us clear some important rules. There are some situations where we should absolutely not change the tense. The first one is, if the reporting verb is in the present or the future tense, the tense of the direct speech do not change. For example, he said, I come. Here said it is reporting verb. It is in past tense. If it is in present or the future tense, the tense of the direct speech do not change in indirect speech. He says, I come. He says that he comes. Next one is, the tense may not change if the statement is still relevant or if it is a universal or general truth or it is a true fact or something was just said. For example, he said, I am left-handed. It is direct speech. In indirect speech, he said that he is left-handed. This is the fact which is true. Universal truth means here, the teacher said the sky is blue. It is direct speech. In indirect also it remains the same. The teacher said that the sky is blue. So now let us see how the tense are changed. The first one is simple present. It becomes simple past in indirect speech. The formula of simple present tense is subject plus be1 plus object. So subject means here, first part of the sentence is called subject. V1 means it is a main verb which expresses state or the action of the subject. Object means here, last part of the sentence is called object. He said, I come. I, it is subject, come, it is V1. Here there is no object. You can also add an object like, I come to your house, I come to college. In indirect speech, he said that. So already you know that where we have to use the word that in the place of comma or inverted comma or if the statement is an assertive sentence. Here first person pronoun I changes into third person he. V1 come it becomes V2 in indirect speech. So what is the difference between simple present and simple past? The difference is nothing but the V1 main verb that changes into V2. Next tense is present continuous. It becomes past continuous in indirect speech. Subject plus HV means here helping verb plus V4 plus object. In present continuous, we use the present form of the helping verbs. They are also known as auxiliary verbs or to be forms. Here we use only three helping verbs such as am, is, and are. Am it is used with first person singular, is it is used with third person singular, are it is used with plural. V4 means here the main verb, here we add ing to the main verb. She said, I am looking for my keys. I it is subject, am it is helping verb, looking it is V4, for my keys it is an object. In indirect speech, she said that the first person pronoun changes into third person she. Here, the helping verb am it changes into was because this is past continuous tense. In past continuous tense, we use past form of the helping verbs. Here we use only two helping verbs, was and were. Was it is used with singular, were it is used with plural. Past form of am and is was, past form of are is were. She was looking for her keys. So looking for her keys, before and object of the sentence remains the same. Next tense is present perfect. Present perfect tense becomes past perfect in indirect speech. Subject plus have or has plus V3 plus object. perfectives we use the have forms of the helping verb. Have and has. Have it is used with plural form. Has it is used with singular form. She said, I have lived in Delhi. In indirect speech, she said that she pronoun first person changes into third person. She had. Here in past perfect tense, we use the only helping verb had because this is the past form of have and has. Next, V3 form of the main verb and object remains the same. So, next tense is, so present perfect continuous becomes past perfect continuous. Formula of present perfect continuous tense is subject plus have or has been plus before plus object. They say it has been raining since morning. It is subject, has this helping verb. Here it subject, it is singular, so because of that the helping verb has is there. Been raining since morning. Been this also helping verb here. Raining it is before. In indirect speech, they said that the pronoun it remains the same. Had, past form of has is had, been, before raining and other part of the sentence that remains the same. Next tense is simple past, it becomes past perfect. In direct speech, if the tense is simple present, that becomes simple past in indirect speech. If the tense is simple past, in direct speech, that becomes past perfect. Subject plus we do plus object. He said, I made notes. I subject made this we do notes. It is an object. He said that he had made notes. So here he pronoun. I changes to third person. He had. We have used the helping verb had because this is perfect tense. Made V2 that becomes V3. Notes and object of the sentence. Next, past continuous becomes past perfect continuous. In past continuous, we use the helping verb was and were. Subject plus helping verb plus before plus object. The kids said, we were playing a game. We it is subject, were it is helping verb, playing it is before, a game it is an object of the sentence. In indirect speech, the kids said, reported. Reporting speech remains the same that they, we pronoun changes into they, third person plural, had, been. Here in the place of verb, we have used had been because this is past perfect continuous. In past perfect continuous, we use the only helping verb had. Playing a game, before and object of the sentence remains the same. Next, past perfect that remains unchanged in indirect speech. It means in direct speech if the tense is past perfect, in indirect also it becomes past perfect. For example, formula is subject plus had plus V3 plus object. She said, I had attended the class. In indirect, she said that she had attended the class. So, next tense is future tense. In future tense, we use modal auxiliary verbs. Here, we just change the models. Have a glance over these models. In direct speech, we use the models like will, can, shall, may, must. In indirect speech, will it becomes would, can, could, shall, should, may, might, must, had. So, if in direct speech, if the models are like would, could, should and might, in indirect or in reported speech, they remain unchanged. So, let us know the example. Rohit said, I will come. Rohit said that I, first person pronoun changes into third person, he, will, it becomes would. The main verb V1 it remains unchanged because here we have changed the model. In the place of will, if can is there, then in indirect speech it becomes could. Rohit said, I can come. Rohit said that he could come. Or in the place of will or can, if would is there, then in indirect speech here the model do not change, it remains the same. Rohit said I could come. In indirect speech Rohit said that he would come. So this is about the future tense. I hope you have understood it, but this is not enough. Still, the more details will be known very soon. So thank you for watching.